Hello there. I thought I'd make a quick guide on the 1 plus 2 Huey method, which is probably the best way to farm this for drops and also for pet. Just assuming that the drop rates work similar to next, just how I assume they work, and I think others do as well. For this method, you're going to want two alts. You can use more than two alts if you want. It would make it a little bit more consistent, but it doesn't really matter too much. It barely loses any time. For the alts, for their inventories, you want to be running basically a full inventory of food, a couple prayer pots or restores, Divine Super Combat, and then bring an Ursine Chain Mace to spec, as well as a full Blood Moon switch. That's what I'm using on both my alt accounts. Bring Thralls on both accounts if you have them. I only have them on one account, so unfortunately I'm losing a little bit of damage to that. For the main account, just rock the max damage setup that you have. I don't have Inquisitor, which I think is better. I might be wrong. But I'm just using full Torva, Dragon Hunter Lance on Crush. And then I have Dragon Claws as a spec weapon. I would be using the Ursine Chain Mace if I had that. And I would also be bringing a full Blood Moon switch if I had that. I don't have either of them. So this is just what I'm using. For the amount of food, I usually use about two mantas per kill, and I'll eat a couple between. So you can do this with a pretty limited amount of space, like you don't need all that much. I usually go in with about this, and I'm pretty fine. Anyway, for the kill, just head on in and start smacking the body. You can use Death Charge here as well. If I had a little bit more space, I'd be using Death Charge to get an extra claw spec during the main part of Huey, but it's not that big a deal. And it's also nice to have a double hit weapon for the tail portion of the fight. If I didn't have the Makas, these Tamalti or whatever they're called, they don't take very long to grind, so they're pretty nice to grab for this. I think it's only like an hour or two of the new boss to get these, so it's definitely worth grabbing before you come here because it'll save a lot of time. And then during this part of the fight, it's pretty chill. So what I do here is this is when I re-gear the two alts. Just deposit the potions that I drank and then get a full inventory of food. And just know every like four or five lance hits, the little circles on the ground are going to pop up and to look back. As I try and drink these guys to full prayer again during this part. It's nice to have like a bank tag that just has the three items you need in it. And then just kind of get them ready to walk into the room. I set my quick prayers on the alts, so that it's piety, and then one of them's praying melee, and one of them's praying mage, and you just put them on the whole time. You don't even bother with switching prayers at all. And with two or three restores, you easily make it through the entire fight without having to switch prayers back. And coming up on the ending here. So there's a lot that happens here. What I do is I pray on both accounts, come in on both accounts, spam click to the boss on this guy, and then click both of these guys up to where the tail's gonna be, and then make sure I resummon my thrall here. You can do two hits before you move. And then you'll have a lot of downtime here. I like to angle the camera, make sure my spec is on, make sure I drink the Divine Combat. Make sure I'm just completely full HP on both the alts. And then once the little ding goes off, do your two claw specs. And these two are just ready that as soon as the tail pops up, they can just both chain mace spec. And what I do on both of them is I just tank everything and just eat an angler every so often. You can combo an angler into a restore as well every couple hits. But yeah, you just basically ignore them, and then just eat an angler whenever you can. I also have it set up so I have the health notifications plugin on, and I have it set up so that if they're below 50% HP, or it's like 30 prayer, the screen will turn a different color. Just makes it easier to see. And also around here, I summon a thrall on the account that can. Once it gets to about 60% HP. And then what I do when the tail comes up is I spec on both and then do a regular hit and then switch to the Blood Moon. So here we go. This is a lot going on here. This is kind of the most intense part of the fight. Put these on, spec the tail on both accounts, do a regular hit while I time this, spec again on both accounts, Blood Moon on. And now I'm looking back at the UIM. Just making sure that it's safe and healthy. And the tail's about to move. I just run over on all three. I'll take a hit here, but that's fine. That's why I bring in extra food. Make sure I have a thrall active. Thrall went away. You can see this guy's low HP, but just monitor it and know that I'm fine. Tail goes down, get back on the boss. Eat the food if I'm scared. And then run these guys back toward the exit, but don't go out of the instance yet. You just want them to be near the entrance. And then just kind of eat food. At some eventual point, I put my armor back on, so I'm not tanking as much damage. But mostly I'm spending like 99% of my focus on the UIM to make sure it doesn't take too much damage. Just whenever you have a good time, just kind of food and restore. Yeah, this ending's like usually pretty simple. And then you have plenty of time between kills to completely restock. Usually about here, I just step out of the room on both of these guys just so they aren't taking any more damage, turn off their prayer. And there's a kill. And then between kills, just slide down and resupply. Which this inventory is getting a little bit scuffed, but should be okay. Got my pots. Yeah, with this, most of my kills are somewhere in the 5 to 6 minute range. I've had one or two kills below 5 minutes, and sometimes kills go a little bit above 6, but usually not too often. Anyway, hope this guide was helpful, and see you later.